How are you today? Time to talk 90 Days Fiancé. So we got two quick stories on 90 Day Fiancé. One, we're going to talk about Natalie and Mike divorce, and then we're going to talk about how the castmates are getting mad at the production company for these fake scenes that they're alleging that they're making them do. So we'll get into all of that. This is going to be good, people. It's going to be good. But before we get into the stories, here's a word from comedian Oval.
Sponsors for the Oval Comedy Show. Oval Comedian can be located on all media outlets. New Music Monday 100 with Wong Cook. YouTube interviewer extraordinaire Sherelle's World. Love and Laugh with Perry Sanders on YouTube. Genesis Community Home, sponsored by Antoine Tweedy Howe. Never Too Hot for Chef Better, the chef that makes everything better.
Save your seat. It's a comedy show you don't want to miss.
Okay, guys, let's talk about this shit show that they give the nickname 90 Day Fiancé, but they really should call it the shit show. It's getting worse and worse each day, second, minute, by the hour. Oh my God. I mean, I can't believe this used to be my favorite show on television. It's just gone downhill. Like, yoop. Okay. I can't take it anymore. I can't take it. But if you've been watching this season of 90 Day Fiancé, you'll know that on last episode, Mike does not marry Natalie. And not only does he not marry her, he wants his ring back. But then we know, shoot to real time, that they really did get married, and that marriage certificate has been circling the internet, I would say, probably since episode two. Okay? So, okay, why are we watching if we already know that these two are going to get married? It's not as dramatic as it seems. She's putting off for the cameras. What the hell is going on? We don't give a damn anymore, right? Well, that's what I thought. But now, Uncle Bo is making this shit show three times worse. Okay, he's going around saying that Mike and Natalie are divorced. They're divorced. She lives in a different place. Making it seem like that she set him up only really to come to the U.S. Well, that would make more sense now, doesn't it? She did not even pretend like she liked him. The only thing she complained about all season, where's my ring? Where's my ring? Are we going to marry yet? Are we going to marry? She not married him out of love. And as a matter of fact, she acted like she couldn't stand him. And so now we realize that he was feeling it, but he took the bait anyway and married this woman. And now she's over here in the U.S. And now what is she going to do? Divorce him. Me personally, I don't give a damn about any of it. I never liked this couple, not one inkling. I cannot stand Natalie. And that's no shade. That's just truth. I don't like her. So I don't care if she's divorced, married. I don't give a damn. But I will say I could tell from the very beginning that she didn't like him and she was just using him. Go think about it, guys. The word love never, ever, ever came out of her mouth. She criticized everything that he did. She acted like he was some fat slob that she just couldn't, you know, wait to get over with. She didn't like the farm. She didn't like Uncle Bo. And every time she thought he wasn't going to take her hand in marriage, then she would be nice for like 5 minutes and then back to old Natalie. This woman is horrible, horrible, horrible. But guess what a subscriber told me? This is very shocking. She says that Natalie, and I'm going to shout you out. Thank you, Princess, for the extra information. I really appreciate it. She says that Natalie has a couple degrees, one in journalism and one in psychology. Now, at first I started laughing. You're a psychology major and you act psycho? But then it all makes sense. No, she knows how to do reverse psychology to get into America. And that's exactly what she was doing. So her masterful plan worked. Mike, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. You got played on national television, okay? She didn't like you, not one inkling, and you took her hand in marriage. She married you, then dumped you, and then move on. She's probably hanging out with her friend from America. What was her name? Svetlana. Okay, I hope I said that right. Svetlana, and they're laughing at you, Mike. You're the biggest idiot on television, okay? Do I feel sorry for him? No. She played him out in the open and not a very good game. We could see this a mile away. She never liked the guy. So it is what it is, people. So another one bites the dust. These couples are not lasting. That's why I missed the old 90 Day Fiancé where the couples last. Like Lauren and Lexi, like Angela and Michael. I mean, these new people, they're just so much. But that leads me into my next story. They're going around crying and complaining. A lot of people are saying that behind the scenes that 90 Day Fiancé is making them shoot these fake scenes. The new cast shoot the fake scenes, and then when they get backlash for it, they get upset about it, and it's things that they didn't want to do. Sounds like a problem, because I would personally say don't shoot the scene if you don't want to shoot the scene, but maybe they have no control over the situation. But we all know that 90 Day Fiancé stage, it's been going around for years. I believe the other day Devin Clegg came on John Yates' channel. Go check out this interview in which she confessed what scenes were fake, what scenes were real. You got Andrew, who is a bona fide jerk, okay? Don't get this twisted. I'm not saying he's a nice guy, but he was saying that they edit certain scenes to look certain ways. I mean, which I totally agree, but that doesn't mean that you're not a nice person. You are a horrible human being, but still a victim of editing and fake scenes and all of that. Of course, behind the scenes, I've been hearing this for so long, it's not even funny. I mean, they've been saying it for the longest. But now you got people coming out admitting it in public. There was David's Lana that came out and admit these scenes are fake. I mean, it's just a mess. And you would think, if I've heard these rumors, Sharp Entertainment and TLC have heard the rumors, they know what's going on, they know that their fakeness is not working anymore, stop. Just stop and put more realness back into the scripts. But no such luck. They just keep doing it until they've turned 90 Day Fiancé into the biggest shit show there ever is. I mean, it's just bad. I know people hate it when I complain about it. I'm not liking it, guys. I'm only agreeing to shoot one more season, to review one more season, because of Angela, who I know is real, and they're bringing back baby girl Lisa and Usman. That's just sheer entertainment right there. But besides that, you know, I just don't, the new cast, whatever, you guys got to start being more forthcoming in your contracts. You have to say, I will not agree to shoot a fake scene if I don't like it. Okay, that's the only way to stop this. But in the meantime, they're getting railroaded. They're not paid a lot. I mean, no shade, it's just true. Unless you have some years behind you like Angela. But in the beginning, you're not getting paid a lot. You're shooting these fake scenes that ruin your reputation and make you mud where you can't go on and work somewhere else. It's like a never ending cycle over there. It's really bad, and someone's gotta be strong enough to break the cycle, or at least smart enough to say, listen, I'll shoot for the cameras. My way, not your way, my way, because at the end of the day, it's my reputation that counts. All right, you guys, that's the two stories I have for you today. Let's talk about it down in the comment section. Is anyone surprised that Natalie and Mike are divorced? I mean, we've seen this coming a mile away, right? I mean, no one's sad about this. And then what do you guys think about Sharp Entertainment and TLC actually ruining people's careers with these phony scenes? It's just ridiculous. I mean, if there's a solution, if anyone has a solution, tell me about it down in the comment section. In the meantime, if you like this video, don't forget to click that like button. If you haven't already subscribed and hit the notification bell, don't forget to do that. I'll meet you guys down in the comment section. We have a lot to talk about today. Until next time, bye for now.